Sima Dome was one of the largest and densest Joshua tree forests in the world. It was really magical.
I thought it was so unique. It was so picturesque, you know, this thick, dense black brush with these Joshua trees coming up through it. I thought that was the coolest vegetation alliance that we had in the entire preserve. I thought that was just phenomenally beautiful.
Lightning ignited a fire in Mojave National Preserve on August 15th of 2020 on Sima Dome. Winds pushed the fire through this beloved wilderness as firefighters worked to slow the progress of the blaze. Many other fires were burning in California at the time, so air assistance was not available for the first few days. The Dome fire ended up burning 43,000 acres and over a million Joshua trees.
When I came out here, I had to prepare myself for the worst, and as you can see, it pretty much was the worst. Miles and miles and miles of just burned landscape.
It had burned so hot and so intense that it was a moonscape. The blackbrush Joshua tree is gone and it'll never come back.
Unlike in many forest ecosystems, the desert is not a fire-adapted ecosystem, and fire should not be present. It really opens the door to bringing in invasive plants that don't belong here. Our native plants just grow so slowly, take so much time to recover from the process of fire that shouldn't be here anyway. And those non-natives really are able to take advantage of that and come back and take over an area.
They'll cause these ecosystems to burn more frequently. And even like the fire-adapted shrubs, the native plants that can withstand some amount of fire, eventually will die out and not be able to return.
Here in Joshua Tree National Park, in contrast to the Mojave Preserve, we have a lot more of the invasive grasses that you see here. Historically, when we would have lightning events, those fires would not spread because there was no carrier fields. There was no grasses to move the fire around. So those fires would stay very small and they would go out pretty quickly. Now, as you can see, the grasses have taken over and they become the primary carrier of the fire. So when we get a lightning fire or a human-caused fire, it becomes incredibly difficult for us to stop the fire and keep it small now.
So here's a good fire follower here. This is a Lycium andersonii, boxthorn, and it it does really well after fire. As you can see, it's already starting to resprout just from a small amount of precipitation that happened right after the fire. So that's really what we're gonna be watching for is more precipitation, because if it rains out here, then you know we'll start to see like the native grasses kind of come back, but we really need to see more rain this winter.
We do wanna see the Joshua tree persist. So we would like to assist the native vegetation in reestablishing and persisting. And I think that if we wind up with something like that, a native grassland, Joshua tree, pinyon juniper savanna, that would probably be the ideal outcome.